Hello friends, welcome back to the learning space. I am Amol, your friend, mentor and guide. I hope you liked the last video on grooming. Today we've got another interesting video which will be very important for you. The COVID situation has certainly put us into a spot. Now we do meet people, but not personally, but virtually. And we are actually committing all our meetings and social engagements virtually through online platforms. Today's video is all about what you should do at a virtual meeting. What should be your online meeting etiquettes? And I'm going to be very, very specific regarding professional online or virtual meeting. My video is going to be into three parts. Number one, what you should do before meeting, what you should do during the meeting, and what you should do after the meeting. So let's start with what is it that we should do before the meeting. Before the meeting, you should ensure that you have all the right coordinates of the meeting. That means the link, the video link for the meeting, the meeting ID and password. You should also have the meeting agenda with you. The meeting agenda will discuss or mention about the subject matter you're going to discuss at the meeting, the attendees in the meeting, and what is it that they're going to achieve through the meeting. So an agenda is a snapshot or a prototype of the virtual meeting which is going to be there. The agenda will help you prepare yourself on a subject matter well. So let's understand, if this online virtual meeting is about creating a marketing strategy for your product, and your part being a senior manager marketing is to suggest few strategies, then you should be well prepared on those. And that's why the agenda. Before the meeting, you should also check if your bandwidth, Wi-Fi and other internet connection is well in place. They should be stable. I would recommend you to keep a backup connection at hand. Like, I prefer keeping my mobile hotspot as a backup connection in case my Wi-Fi goes off. Ensure that you have your diary in place. A diary and pen will help you take notes and also raise pertinent questions whenever required for. Ultimately, listening at virtual meeting is an important art. We'll come back to that later in our other videos, but let's focus upon attending the online meeting today. Before the meeting, you should ensure what kind of dress you're going to wear today. It's like any other professional meeting, you should be dressed up in a nice formal attire. If you are wearing a suit, a tie, or a formal shirt, nothing like that. But ensure that you wear that formal attire during the meeting. Before the meeting, you should choose a place to sit and attend where you have sufficient amount of light coming right in front of you. The light should fall on your face. It should not be behind you. Choose a corner or a room in your house or in your office where you don't get to listen to the external noises, where the external noises are barred. There's no disturbance around you. There's nobody moving around you when you're attending the business meeting online. You should also ensure that your voice is perfectly projected, and so you can use a collar mic for that. If not, you can also use the earphone mic, but in short, it is placed properly so that it can catch your voice. Now let's come down to the start of meeting now. What you should do during the meeting. So we have taken our place, a corner, a nice corner in our house from where we are going to attend this meeting. We have settled down, we have got a diary and a pen with ourselves. Our internet connection is running perfectly well. And now you are logging into your meeting. So you log into the meeting with your credentials. And when you log into the meeting, there are others who are also joining in. So first thing you do is rename yourself. You rename yourself as per your own designation, position in the company. Let's say if you are meeting an external client, you would like to mention like senior manager of finance or senior manager of marketing or senior manager of product management in so-and-so company. That would be a longish form of name, but then it helps you as a visiting card. If it's an internal meeting, you can keep it short, like senior manager of finance, Amol, or senior manager, Amol. But that helps recognizing who is attending the meeting and what is your designation. Once you are into the meeting, take somebody's help to check your audio and visuals. Ensure that you are visible and you are audible. Let somebody help you with this. So speak few sentences or word and let somebody give you feedback to place yourself in a position where you can be audible and nicely visible. As the meeting starts, and if it is not your turn to speak, you can mute your sound and you can put off your video. That helps in two ways. Number one, it does not disturb the meeting. And number two, it helps you save your bandwidth. Three, there can be some lighter movements in the meeting, but don't get carried away. This is a professional meeting with a clear agenda. So stick to the agenda so that you can finish the meeting in stipulated time. A meeting which goes on for 1.5-2 hours is good enough. But let's understand, this is not a social gathering platform where we can joke around with our friends. So keep the sanctity of the meeting as it is intact. During the meeting, don't forget to take notes from when the important people speak. If it is your client, if it is your stakeholder, if it is your superior subordinate, ensure you take valid points in your notebook. This again helps you in two things. Number one, maintaining the flow of meeting, and number two, asking pertinent questions whenever required for. If you want to take a small bio break, what you should do? I generally raise my hand, announce that I want to take a 2 minute bio break, and then leave the meeting. I don't end the meeting, I just leave the meeting and come back to join in. If you need to ask a question, the protocol would be again to raise a hand or type into the chat box. Once you raise a hand, you will get an opportunity to ask a question there. But please don't talk over somebody else. It's a virtual meeting anyways. There would be a little bit of lag. So it should not happen that everybody is talking at the same time and we are not able to listen to anyone else. So let other people have their chance and then you speak when your turn comes in. Now, the meeting is coming towards the end. But there's something very important which you should always keep in mind. Whenever you are talking in the virtual meeting, ensure that you are looking into the camera. When you're looking into the camera, you make a perfect eye contact with your audience. The audience is looking at their screen and you are looking at the camera. It's a perfect combination. Ensure that you keep that winning smile always on your face and a confident look on your face. Now, we have come towards the end of the meeting. What we should do? I will tell you. We should first summarize whatever we have discussed. We should clearly understand what my part or task would be after this meeting to do. So, it may be possible that you have been assigned a certain task during the meeting and you have written it down. Just summarize and recheck and paraphrase it so that people correct you if you have missed a point. Once you have summarized the meeting, discuss the next course of action. You can also inquire about the next meeting schedule and the expected deliverables from your end. Once you are done with this compact rechecking, just say goodbye by waving your hand on the screen. This tells audience that you are about to leave the meeting. And of course, be courteous, say nice goodbye, see you again, take care, and then leave the meeting. I hope you liked the video again today and you must have found the tips useful for your online and virtual meetings. Please write us your suggestions and feedbacks or any question on twoignitingminds@gmail.com. I will repeat, it's numeric 2ignitingminds@gmail.com. I am sure you're going to share, like, and subscribe to this channel. Till we meet again with an interesting topic in our next video. Take care. I'll see you there very soon. Goodbye.